I worked at a portrait studio in Alabama for many years. It's very exciting. Portrait studio. We're coming up on portrait studio season. Yeah, where mothers dress up their children in scratchy clothes they don't normally ever wear. Mostly with a tag still attached. And put them in rooms or fields. They put a really nice couch in the middle of a field where it doesn't belong. Let's all get on this couch, right? Like, or let's go to the portrait studio with lights you've never seen before. And they bring a kid in this foreign environment and scratchy clothes and go, smile, just smile, act normal, smile, smile. And the kid's like, la, la. Mom's like, you were normal a minute ago. What happened to you? I don't know what's happening at all, right? And dads hate the portrait studio. Dads hate portraits. They are drugged there by the scruff of their neck with promises of like a night out with the guys or extra uninterrupted football. They don't give a shit about any of this. But moms have this feeling like they want to involve dad in this family decision about the portraits. And all they're doing is asking questions to get angry at the dad. All right, so which one do you think we should get? I don't really care. I know, but this one has a smile like that smile he does when he's about to eat peanut butter. But this one, he has a smile like that one smile he did that one time that I really love. But this one, I like everybody but me, so that one's out. And this one... I had a mom one time order a wall portrait where the dad's eyes were closed because she looked the best. That's how little dads matter. So inevitably, they turn to him and go, well, what size should we get? Like an 8x10. How big is an 8x10 again? Oh. It's 8 inches by 10 inches. Okay, all right. Well, how big is a 5x7? It's 5 inches by 7 inches. Okay, all right. How big is a 20x20? Oh my God! Someone made a baby with you on purpose? How did that happen? Makes me so angry inside. So like, what should we get, an 8x10 or 5x7? I'll get an 8x10. No, that will never fit. We're gonna get a 5x7. What do you think your mama wants? I don't think she cares. Well, can you call her? Like, oh. And so we sit there, and in Alabama, a phone call to relatives takes 5 times as long as Minnesota. Even in Minnesota, you know how you guys do the leading, thing that you guys do before you say stuff? Even with that, if you've never lived in Minnesota, if you call someone on the phone in Minnesota, they go, oh, hey, so hi there, yeah. See, I just wonder, and you're like, what were those 16 syllables? I don't even, what? In Alabama, they go, hey, how are you? All right, well, we're here at the portrait studio, and they've got one picture of all of us together, and the baby is making that face like where they eat the peanut butter. And the other face, right there, what? Okay, I'll wait, hold on. I'm like, I'm gonna die right now. Do you want a 5x7 or, hold on. No, it's 5 inches by 7 inches. An 8x10, it's 8 inches by 10 inches. I don't know what we got last time. Go find a ruler. I'm like, oh, Jesus Christ. Nobody likes your kids that much. They're never going to hang that picture up. Because here's the deal. Babies are adorable, but 6-year-olds, like the one you have, look like squirrels with huge teeth. You know? Because they have the adult teeth and the tiny head and the confused look in their eyes. Shit's disgusting. From 6 to 9, it's a weird thing. Wait till they're 16 and look weird, quasi-sexual, make everybody uncomfortable. Put a wall portrait of that. But right now, skip it. Skip this year. The whole portrait experience is just so that mom can send pictures to everyone and go, it was not a mistake to make a baby with that weird guy. And we are very happy right now. For the 1/160th of a second it took to take this picture, we were very happy. With 3 head swaps, we look very happy. I mean, babies are cute, right? And grown-ups are okay, but that middle section is a woof. And moms lose their minds. Like, I'm a mom now, and I get it that you're under a lot of pressure, but God, we're so crazy. One time, I posed a 10-day-old baby in the most gorgeous, perfect position, and the baby smiled, and I got it, and I'm like, huzzah! And the mom goes, I feel like that smile looks really fake. The baby's only been here 10 days. How do you know that's a fake smile? He's only been here 240 hours. You know why he's fake smiling? Because he can't live up to your expectations. You crazy person. I like working at the Portrait Studio because when the customers leave, I like to lean over the counter and watch them go by with their groceries because I didn't say it was classy. Walmart! And one time this guy walks by with a girl and she looks and she goes, "Oh my God, do we have everything we need?" And he goes, "Well, black garbage bags, bleach, rubber gloves, duct tape." And I went, "Whoa, how many bodies are you guys trying to hide?" She goes, "Our dad just died and we're cleaning out his apartment." I'm like, "So just the one then, huh?" "Sounds like you guys need an updated family picture." But the one that really made me want to lose it was a lady came in and goes, "I just love all them sideways pictures y'all took, but my frames don't go that way." I'm like, Jesus Christ. How do your brain cells get enough energy together to go, "We should breathe now"? Like, how does that...